it's important for it's important for us today to stand in front of the board director to deliver a presentation. So today's presentation is about acceptance of Airbus A380 at Lapangan Terbang Sultan Azman Shah LTSAS Ipoh. So hopefully our presentation today will provide you some insight and perhaps the idea how we will propose in regards of the airport expansion, and also how we will conduct to execute the order project, especially the ORI. So in this presentation, our group will cover 8 points, which is the company background, what was the background, airport overview, terminal building upgrades, airfield upgrades, ORI, and also completion. So that's the points for our presentation today. So next, let's move on to our company background. So our company name is DNN Consulting Malaysia Sdn. Which is located in Sago Jaya. Our team member is?
My name is Deidre Jensen Sanda. I'm the Senior Engineer Manager under the Engineering Division.
My name is Najatul Naimah, VP Mohamad Issa. My role is Senior Project Manager under Project Management Division.
My name is Nur Akira Azmi, Senior Project Manager under Construction Service.
So this is our proposal background. So why we need to expand the Lapangan Terbang Sultan Azman Shah, or which we call Ipoh Airport, because from the trend that we see that the passenger and tourists keep increasing, and then in addition to that, based on the newspaper, we did research on we found that they say that the current terminal is very limited, whereby people arrival and departure holding the same area. So that's why the reason we need to expand the building, and then they want it to have a separate floor for arrival and departure. So also that there are statistics showing that every year the passenger movement is keep increasing, and we predict that in 2000 we forecast that 2019 passenger will keep increasing. So this is the proposal brief. The proposal brief is the acceptance of Airbus A380 at Lapangan Terbang Ipoh, and our proposed contract amount is 5 million. This is the total overall contract, for our total overall cost, the proposed project duration is 4.5 years, and we propose our proposed start of construction is starting in January 2020 and proposed start of operation in July 2023. Okay, this is the overall high-level project timeline. So we have 5 phases here, which is a preparation phase took 1 year, planning phase will take 1 year, construction phase we divide into two stages, which is stage 1 and stage 2, and then we target to start operation on July 2023, and then the operation phase will start on January 2024. So basically, this is the high-level process of how the expansion will be conducted. And then for the preparation phase, we will conduct feasibility study to check whether to analyze whether it's feasible enough to go ahead, because it's the there are like the projects as good. And then the important is that the sub-process, the very important is alright. Because in ORI, we will check all the operation and then whether it's good enough to continue to the operation. So this is the breakdown of the construction phase. We divided into two stages, which is the first stage. Our focus area is land side, which is to fulfill this scope of work. We focus on the airport facilities, and then the ground handling, which is the terminal operation. And then the second stage is will take around 6 months. And our focus on the air side is runway and taxiway, and also the apron. Okay, so without further ado, I pass the floor to my team member to explain about the airport overview.
Okay.
So the next discussion will be about the network overview. So here you can see that I will explain to you more about the airport details, which is the current airport that we are proposing for the upgrade for the acceptance of A380 will be Sultan Hassan Shah Airport, known to be as the airport, people airport. And the airport codes is PH for IATA, IATA, and WMKI for ICAO. So for the current business model for the Mexico Airport, as we know that it is currently under the relation of airport holdings, mainly now Ipoh Airport is focusing on aeronautical revenue, which for now Ipoh Airport only serves full service carriers, low cost carriers, and also hybrid carriers. As you can see here, Ipoh Airport flies to various region destinations. It includes Singapore Airlines, Scoot Airlines, Set Airlines, Asia, Malindo Air, and in 27 November, Ipoh Airport will start to fly to Guangzhou, China, under Skanda Sky Airlines. Okay, so now I proceed to the current airport layout, which this is the runway configuration. As you can see here, Ipoh Airport only consists of single runway, which landing and takeoff will take place in only one terminal, only one runway. And on the next one will be the taxiway and airport configuration. Going back to the runway configuration, for the current runway, the size of it is only for 2,000 meters and the width is 45 meters. Next, you can see here is the taxiway and apron configuration, which currently Ipoh Airport only consists of 3 aprons and 5 taxiway, which is not compatibility with A380 aircraft, which is the 4F code. Later on, my colleague here will explain more on the applications of the A380 compatibility with Ipoh Airport. And as you can see here, the current terminal is under a simple linear concept airport. And in my further slides, I will propose to you and I will explain more to you on the operation of the terminal. So you can see here is the current airport facilities data that for the runway, as I explained just now, it's length is 2,000 meters, the width is 45 meters, and the bearing strength currently is 77 tarmac. And for the apron surface strength, it's under rigid concrete, and they only have 3 aprons. And for the taxiway, there's only 5 taxiways, and it's under asphalt flexible. Okay, so for the next slide, this is the current airport facilities, which Ipoh Airport, we know, it's a very has limited handling service and facilities, which Ipoh Airport doesn't have cargo handling facilities. It doesn't have fuel or oil fueling facilities and capacity, and the hangar and the repair facilities is limited, and it does not an A4F code aircraft is not compatible with the all the repair facilities. And later on, we will discuss more about the operations and modifications. And for the next one will be the airport and passenger facilities. As here, the airport doesn't have any hotels built in the surround the airport. And restaurants, cafeterias, and shops are limited in the airport terminal buildings as well. The transportation are limited to only taxi service and car rentals for now. And there is no medical facilities, and there is no bank and post office or even tourist office. So in this situation, we are looking at everything we need to get in the city. So in this proposal, we will be talking about the operations of every of these facilities. So, moving on, this is I'm going to explain to you about the terminal buildings upgrades. But there will be two main upgrades and modifications that we are proposing to you today. So we are looking into an extension of a new building, which consists of ground handling operations and airport facilities operations. So in this ground handling terminal operations upgrade and modification, we are looking to accommodate with baggage check, which includes priority land to the first of business class, economy land for premium or economy class, or the third one will be our current advanced technology, which is the self-baggage drop system, which you do not have, which is you can still pass counter check-ins and just drop your baggage in all the available self-baggage counters. And the next one will be the baggage handling, which the security screening system will be increased. It will be accommodated to the advanced technology of the security level. And the next one will be baggage clamp, which now we are looking into advanced and fast automated baggage system, which is possible. We can avoid delay baggage or easy checking baggage system. And the next one will be the ticketing and the check-in, which as well includes priority lane for first and for business class, economy lane for premium or economy class, and an advanced kiosk for self-check-in. And the next operations will include security as well as to upgrade and to add more security to prevent and control the airport security for any needs that we do not want to it to happen. And for the last one, for the last operation that we are looking into, which is the passenger with reduced mobility assistance. This will cater to the priority and special attention to PRM, which will assist the people that is in need and give them the easy access for all of this. For the airport, for the ground handling terminal operations. So moving on to the second major upgrades that we are looking into, which is the airport facilities. Which currently it's a very very limited airport has a very very limited airport facilities, which as you can see, 4F4 aircraft, the A380 Airbus, will consist major we are looking into a very large crowd, which we think that the first one to upgrade, which is the airport lounge, we are looking into accommodating the airport facilities airport lounge, giving special and privileged benefits to the first class passengers, to the business class passengers, as well as to the passengers or customers that paid for the launch membership. And moving on to the next one, will be the toilet, both in arrival hall and departure hall, as this is a very important facilities that we need to equip in the airport, in the new terminal building. And moving on to the next one will be the public transport. We need to improve more on the parking lots, the availability and the service of car rental as well as taxi services. And the next one will be the waiting area at the departure hall as well as the arriving hall, where we need to give the most comfortable and larger space for the crowd that we are expecting to have in the coming future. So, and for the next operation, we find it very very important will be the food and beverage and the retail stores, which currently Ipoh Airport is has a very limited in cafe and restaurant, souvenir shop and convenience store. As Ipoh Airport is going to welcome more international passengers, mainly we are looking into first class passengers, Ipoh Airport needs good and better cafe, restaurants, souvenir shops, or even convenience store, and more choices for them to choose. And moving on to the last upgradation will be the other services, which includes clinics, ATM machines, money changer, banks, and the airport signage and wayfinding, and also the information counter is also important to look at in the other services that are in the new terminal building. All these need to be equipped to fulfill the satisfactions of the passengers and together as well for the customers that will be in the airport. And moving on is the airfield upgrades, and I'm going to pass this to my member.
I'm going to explain to you about airfield upgrades. For runway and taxi bay upgrade, first is runway. We need to expand the size of runway, which can accommodate 8 feet. And second, to upgrade the runway type of bay that suit with 8 feet. Second is taxiway. The modification of taxiway to accommodate and fit 8 feet in the new terminal building. And I'm going to explain about the proposed taxiway to accommodate 8 feet. Based on the compatibility studies, 8 feet is the subsonic long range and high capacity civil transport aircraft. Basically, and 8 feet have been using by world class airlines because it's a wide body craft and too compact for passenger load. So second is comparison of aircraft dimension. Currently, at Ipoh Airport, we have 4C type of aircraft, which is A320 and B737. So in future, we're gonna accommodate A380. In future, we need to upgrade runway and taxiway for this airport, because the number of passengers is going to increase from 180 to 555 maximum. Next, based on this compatibility studies, comparison of airfield dimension. Based on ICAO, for code F, the runway width needed is 40 meters, but Ipoh Airport currently is 45 meters. So in term 2, 880, we need to follow with ICAO code F, which is 60 meters. And then the runway length for code F aircraft needed is 3,500 meters above. But currently in Ipoh Airport, it's 250 meters, which is not meet the ICAO criteria for A380. So we propose 3,500 meters for to fit with A380 aircraft. So for the runway surface, based on ICAO for that is asphalt, because based on a few case studies that I do, mostly biggest airline that stop. But currently in Ipoh, they're using tarmac. Tarmac is a mixture of concrete, cement, and other mineral sources. So it's a bit higher than asphalt. Asphalt is a mixture with concrete. So based on the current effort from tarmac, we propose to asphalt because asphalt is mostly being used in another biggest effort, and it's in terms of maintenance, it's cheaper and easy to repair based on tarmac. Based on maintenance, it's expensive and hard to repair. So for the test width, is ideal for F is 25 meters. For the current airport is 24, so we propose to 25. So taxi surface we maintain with asphalt, and apron surface we maintain with the concrete. So this one is the,
as you can see, this is actually the virtual look of the proposed operation that we propose to you.
So for second major upgrade is on apron upgrade based on ground handling services. So currently in Ipoh Airport, for ground services handling, mostly available on request, but to fit with A380 in the future, so we need to propose boarding bridges because from 180 passengers to 555 passengers. Okay. And then second is for core refueling facilities. Currently in Ipoh Airport, there is no refueling facilities except based on request. The team proposed category truck services because A380 is long haul services, daily services. So we need to accommodate more load in category trucks for return flight. And then four proposed to Trax and Toba for this
Okay, now I will continue to the operational readiness activation. Operational readiness activation and transition. In this section, I will provide the high level concept of the ORAC, and then what is our approach to conduct the ORAC. Okay, this is what the ORAC. So basically, ORAC is the sub process in terms of the overall project. So the purpose is to identify and then to mitigate the risk in project before any operational impact can occur. So this is the prerequisite of the ORAC. You must have the facility, information system, and human resource. And then when we speak about ORAC, ORAC is about the operation. So we must know what are the main core of process of the airport. So basically, this is the core process of the airport, which is this is the area that we need to look to process to improve in order for us to accommodate the AJ in acceptance. So based on the core process, we identify that that we need to improve this process of pet crew handling in terms of the signage, flight information system, and then another area to process to improve and then to revise is the how the baggage handling in terms of departing and arrival time. Except for cargo, because airport improve, there is no cargo or mail handling process. And then next one, the core process that we need to focus on is the ground handling, which is the aircraft handling services and handling support unit. This is, I believe this one is already the equipment or things that we need to upgrade that has been presented by my friends before. And then also the core process that we need to improve and revise is the aircraft control. We look into in terms of the navigational aids, visual aids, dynamic space management, and also the ATC. Of course, the admin and management core process that we need to revise in terms of the facility and system management, because we expand another terminal. So the main function of terminal in terms of the loading maintenance, electrical system maintenance, drainage and equipment, refueling facilities that we need to look into the process as a whole role. Okay, so the next one is the airport security. There's an airport security, of course, because A380 bring almost like 500 passengers. So of course we need to tighten our security and improve our current security in the current building. As well as customer service, because we're providing more customer service facilities as well as the environment. So this is the our proposed approach and timeline how we're going to conduct the ORAD deployment. So basically we are divided into two stages, which is the stage one, we look into the strategy, and then the stage two in terms of the tactical. So from definition, planning, execution, and acceptance and activation handover, we allocate around estimated 1.5 years to conduct the first stage of the ORAD and the half stage of the second stage. And then the rest is after the airport opening date, it will take about 6 months in order to do the transition and ownership. So basically stage one, we divide stage one and stage two. Stage one, we connect, we specify into the strategy, we do the planning in terms of stakeholders and management, and then preparing people, which is we plan for the training. This is the important part whereby we need to look into the operation, which is map back to the operation that we do, that need to improve. And then this is where the certification process will take place. And then this is the testing. The important part is testing and trial execution, whereby before the operation of the A380 operate, we need to look into the process, which we need to identify the risk and mitigate it before it enter the operation. So next, this is the ORAD testing trial execution, whereby this is the overall process. The overall process, we need into this area. And then this area. This is, we map back to the process that I presented before. So, we will check in terms of the process flow and the smoothness of the messages from the arrival and departure. And we can see here, there are airport essential services, there are fire, so the fire rescue services that we were going to propose to upgrade from the category 6, which is currently an import, is category 6, and we propose to upgrade to category 10. So, it depends on the aircraft 10. So next, the conclusion, I will call our team member to conclude each of them.
So basically, for the terminal building, for ground handling operations and airport facilities operations, of course, we are looking at passenger satisfaction, customer experience, ensure high diversity within operation, and we are looking into advanced system, of course, revenue generations for people as well.
Next,
that's
conclusion for the
F3
upgrading for runway and taxiway. The purpose of expansion for the runway is to be the A380 aircraft, white body, landed sandy runway, taxiway, and most importantly, to avoid collision with another aircraft. Comparison will be between the three aircraft, which is A320, E77, and A380. So for the airport upgrading, finally with a few studies and comparison on A380, details, aircraft details configuration, there's a few things need to be upgraded on SI ground handling in order to accommodate A380 with the smoothness process. The purpose of upgrading sensors at airport area is to meet the requirement needed by the A380 aircraft when it landed on Sultan Hassan Shah Airport. So that is for the all right. The most important thing is the stakeholders management, which is this is the medium where people of the relevant party in the project or the in this activity, we need to understand and their involvement, and then to get everybody in the same page. And then the critical success factor for this expansion project is that stakeholders management, control, change management, and also government interaction is the critical factors of the project success. And the last one is that the familiarization and training, which is when we introduce the system, the new process, all the staff and the employee need to understand what are the revised process in order to accommodate the A380 advice acceptance. So I think that's our presentation today.